I want to zero in on the cloud because Google Cloud has been in third place for a long time now, though the entire cloud pie is growing. They've made a CEO changeover. They've replaced Diane Greene with Thomas Kurian. Colin, what are you expecting when it comes to Google Cloud, and how important is it going to be for the business, given that they haven't been able to beat Amazon or Microsoft in terms of market share?
It still is an important business for Google. It's obviously not the core at all, but it's an important way for Google to diversify their business a little bit. If you look at the way that Google gets revenue, about 85% of revenue at Google is coming from the ad business. And I think, given the competition again that they're going to be facing, you do not want to be in a spot where you have north of 80% of your revenue coming from advertising. So I think that they're going to place a bigger emphasis on the cloud business going forward. How much success are they going to have? I mean, it's kind of hard to say. They haven't been able to get out of that third slot, as you said. They're facing massive competition against Microsoft and Amazon, who have had a lot of success and who do put significant dollars behind that business. So I think that it'll be something that'll be hard to get out of that third slot, but still a significant part of their business that they will be focusing on going forward.
So you wonder if acquisitions will be part of the story to beef up the cloud business. They did buy Looker earlier this year, and I did ask Ruth Porat if acquisitions in cloud specifically would make sense. She said, we're open to acquisitions where they make sense. There's a lot we're doing organically, and we're excited about the opportunity. So she, at the same time, she said they're still interested in acquisitions. She also said the organic business is doing well, but it is certainly interesting, given the antitrust scrutiny, Lee, that Google might hesitate to do more acquisitions, certainly in the near future. Is that what you'd expect?
Actually, I think the cloud business is important strategically for this reason. Look at what Microsoft just did with OpenAI, investing $1 billion in that. I don't even know what you call it. It's not tech. It's a company, but it's kind of a nonprofit. I think Google will look at their cloud business in a similar fashion, where the technologies of the future that will be scaled out, obviously the cloud business is going to be important for that. And it is, in a sense, a platform for those new businesses. So while Amazon will continue to push a lot of that cloud business to the bottom line, and as we have seen today, it's incredibly important to the stock price because it impacts CSOI so heavily, and the bottom line EPS numbers. For Google, I don't see it quite that way. I see it actually even more strategic to Google than it may even be to Amazon.
OpenAI, an artificial intelligence research company, as we refer to it. Colin, let's talk lastly about YouTube. Of course, there's been a lot of question about how YouTube's business can continue to grow. It is one of the centerpieces of where the scrutiny from lawmakers and regulators around the world is coming from, focused on hate speech, misinformation, fake news. YouTube has made a lot of changes. We've done a lot of reporting on internal turmoil at the company, a division under Google, and yet Ruth Porat was very positive about growth on the call with me today. She's echoed some of the same things she said on the earnings call with analysts. How do you expect YouTube to weather these headwinds, Colin?
I mean, the brand safety issues that advertisers have are legitimate on YouTube. That's, as you said, it's been something that's been under spotlight for a while. Google hasn't found a more automated way to figure out how to monitor for those sort of things. It's a very manual, laborious process that they have in place where they're really just using resources to monitor that kind of stuff. But in terms of like headwinds when it comes to YouTube, I'm not really concerned. When you think about Google's package, last year, a big innovation that Google did was basically bring all of their advertising platforms into one, into the Google Marketing Platform, a more comprehensive, holistic stack to offer to advertisers. And the thing that is great about the way that they did this is that Google's able to offer a full customer lifecycle or marketing funnel offering to the marketplace, unlike anyone else is able to do. Facebook's kind of stuck in this early awareness phase, where if you're an advertiser trying to bring awareness about the the product or service you're selling, Facebook's a pretty good place. But if you're looking to convert customers, if you're trying to drive direct response right now, Facebook's not so great for that. Google, on the other hand, is great for both. YouTube is great for awareness because people consume more video content today than they did 5 years ago, and expecting in 5 years there will be 8% growth in video consumption on a weekly basis by U.S. users. So I'm not really concerned about the YouTube business going forward.